Augusta National Golf Club, where on this beautiful, sun-drenched Saturday, a week before the Masters, one of the game's newest traditions returns. Here in golf's most familiar setting, a brand new name will join the very small and special list of champions crowned at Augusta. It's the stuff dreams are made of.
It starts with an invitation, a symbol of possibility, representing the fulfillment of a dream. And an opportunity to experience something extraordinary.
Well done there.
The greatest women's amateur golfers in the world have been summoned to this stage, one of the most magical settings in golf, where they've already written their own history into Augusta's legend.
A champion's finish as Jennifer Kupcho is the winner. 17-year-old Tsubasa Kajitani.
Anna Davis.
This is so good.
The best in the world is a champion at Augusta National, Rose Zhang.
Winning Augusta National with my dad on the bag, those were the really special moments.
It is an invitation that's become the most coveted in women's amateur golf.
Everybody posts about the invitation they get. Everybody wants to go play at Augusta.
And a launching point for the next generation of greats. On the fifth anniversary of this championship, possibility, dreams, and the opportunity of a lifetime once again beckon. Welcome to the 2024 Augusta National Women's Amateur.
From the Augusta National Golf Club in Augusta, Georgia, NBC Sports presents the final round of the Augusta National Women's Amateur. And welcome back to Augusta National Golf Club. It's the first Saturday in April at a place synonymous with the sport and the season. Springtime in Augusta signals the renewal of that new season ahead and the memories that have been made here for generations. And today, on the golf holes where history has been seared into our memories, one of the top women's amateur players in the world will have her moment of a lifetime at Augusta. Our morning temperatures are in the high 30s. That delayed the start this morning by 30 minutes, but once the action got going, it got going with a bang. Ingrid Lindblad, who is a graduate student at LSU, is the number one ranked amateur player in the women's game and got off to a great start with birdies early on at the first and the second. So Lindblad right in the story for the rest of the day. They're all chasing Lottie Wode, who started the day with a two-shot lead and had to struggle but save her par, and the Florida State sophomore stayed at the top of the leaderboard. Are there Chargers? Yes, there are. Maisie Filler, Florida senior, plays her college golf out of Gainesville and playing some good golf here. Look at this, understanding the slope with her third at the second that led to a birdie. Maisie's even for the day and tied for third right now. One of the big moves on the golf course has come from Bailey Shoemaker. What a story it's been for the 19-year-old from Florida, but she's a freshman at Southern California. She has three birdies on her round. At the second, the fifth, and what a great shot here at the seventh to put Shoemaker within two shots of the lead. So here's our leaderboard as we go into this final round. It's Lottie Wode from Florida State, two clear of Shoemaker, then Lindblad, the player who has played in this event before and played well. See only a half dozen players under par, including Hannah Darling, who had the lead after the first of the three rounds in this competition. Get a look at the top 10 and go on back. The low 30 and ties made it to the final round here at Augusta National. So we have 35 players in all who are competing, many of whom have ties to colleges here in the U.S., many of whom you've seen in this event before, or perhaps in the drive, chip, and putt over its first nine plays. Some of the best amateur golfers in the world all competing here for this prestigious prize in this fifth Augusta National Women's Amateur. Mike Tirico along with Morgan Pressel. Paige McKenzie is with us to describe the action as well. Bones, Jim McKay is out there on the golf course with the last group. Steve Burkowski will add some stories about some of the players, and Anna Jackson will join us to talk to the players when they are finished. Let's go out now to the fifth, and there is our leader by two shots, Lottie Ward, one under par on her round. And as you said, Morgan, a couple of times in our coverage on Golf Channel, this is a difficult circumstance because you sleep on the lead when you have the lead, not for one night, but for two nights.
It's a unique part of this competition. Players going from Champions Retreat the first 2 days, having a day off in terms of competition, getting that practice round yesterday here at Augusta National Golf Club, and then teeing it up for real for the final day here. Oh, that looked like a good roll. Her putter has been really hot this week. It's been one of the main reasons she is at the top of the leaderboard, including that really important par save at the first.
She had a nice long two-putt birdie at the second. So there's the card so far for Woad. Clean for the moment. One under par, her first five. We're going to look at the eighth, the second of the par fives on the first nine. And Jasmine Koo has this for eagle to get to even par. That looks good. Yeah. So we had one eagle earlier today at the eighth, and add Jasmine Koo to that list as well, racing a rough patch in the middle of the round. We go over to the play at the ninth. Paige.
And this is Bailey Shoemaker now, just from over the green. Good touch there. Aggressive play to get to this back hole location that she took on with her second shot, but no harm done. And remains the best score on the course today.
Now we're back at the eighth with Hannah Darling, the 20-year-old from Scotland, plays her collegiate golf in Columbia at South Carolina. And she rolls in a birdie. Boy, she made a bunch of them on day one. Eight birdies in her opening round of 66. So she is two under and four behind. This over at 16.
And just a moment ago, Mamika Shinchi. Familiar hole locations in a bit of a bowl. Well done. And that is a memorable moment. Tough day for Mamika, but a highlight with birdie, birdie in 15 and 16. Getting that par three to number six. And Jim Bones McKay down with this group.
Thank you, Paige. Gianna Clement just talking over with her dad, who is on the bag today. 177 back left hole location. Very, very difficult to get to. If you can get a shot here within 25, 30 feet, you've done one heck of a job. Made a little tougher by the fact that the north wind is starting to kick up in their face. Gianna with the rough start, three over through her first four holes, played an incredible fifth, drove it in the middle of the fairway, and then wedged to some 12 feet, poured it in there. She's got a lot of local support out here, which you might imagine given the fact she goes to school quite nearby.
Probably just in between the tower and the flag. 20 feet right.
Trying to draw it in. This ball at the center of the green.
Good shot.
This should come off this slope and release down towards the flag a little.
Come here.
Well done.
Don't want this ball to pick up too much speed now. That is very good.
A lot of players talk about, Bones, on this golf course, you don't have to play perfect because you can use the slopes. You can play it and miss it in the right positions.
No question about it, which is why in past years, I've talked a lot about these young women using local caddies when they play the final round at Augusta National. Lottie Wodenow has done a heck of a job just doing her own thing on the greens thus far. This starts out right at it.
Great shot.
Just a half club short, but a good leave.
And while we have a moment, we'll say hello to Mike and Morgan.
Thank you, Paige, and we welcome everyone inside Butler Cabin, where the champion will be in about 3 hours. This cabin was built in 1964, and boy, the history it's seen over the last six decades, and more of it's right here this afternoon. Year five of this event, Morgan, and you've watched the growth of it. Give me a big picture view of how the Augusta National Women's Amateur fits for women's golf.
It's truly incredible how in just five short years it has become by far the most impactful event in women's amateur golf. And I believe venues are so important. And there is no better example of that than right here at Augusta National Golf Club, where arguably one of the most famous golf courses in the entire world with so much history. And to see these incredibly talented women take on this golf course here under the most pressure they've ever experienced, it has just done wonders for women's golf.
Well, let's talk about that. We do have to remind everyone that the women we're seeing compete are between ages 16 and 24. You won a major championship as a teenager. Give me the perspective of what you've seen in the growth of the game, because the more we see of these players, the more impressive stuff we see out of the best amateurs in the world.
Yeah, and I think you see it starting at drive, chip, and putt as well, and we have some drive, chip, and putt competitors here playing today. And so these players are feeling more and more comfortable playing on these big stages, and I think that we have seen that on this leaderboard already. I mean, Lottie Wode sleeping on that lead for two nights, really coming out strong. Bailey Shoemaker, a really wonderful young talent, has taken the reins of having the best round on the golf course so far and has been very impressive.
So we'll watch some of that, and also the players who we've seen compete here in past playings of this event, like Ingrid Lindblad. As I mentioned earlier, she's the number one ranked amateur in the world. She missed the green here at 7. Her chip was to here. So this is for par at number 7 to remain 3 off the lead. And that was well offline, and speed and pace as well. So Lindblad's going to drop back, as Bailey Shoemaker has made the turn to the famous second nine at Augusta, in great position with her second here at number 10.
Go. Trying to draw something in there, the ball well above her feet.
Oh, like that. And getting better all the time. Beautiful shot by Shoemaker, who has that 3-under par first nine to put herself in position for a charge. If you have not been following during the week, Tuesday the players played a practice round at Champions Retreat, about 10 or 15 minute drive from here. Then the first two rounds were played there, the cut to the top 30 in ties. All the players played not only a practice round here at Augusta National yesterday, also got to play the famed par 3 course. And those who made the cut, 35 in all, competing today in the final round, and one of the 35 to be crowned the fifth champion of this event. Will it be Lottie Wode? Led by 2 to start the day, leads by 2 right now, as we go back to Paige in the play of the 6th.
And I have seen a few putts from this portion of the green early in the day, Bones, and it seems like the player's having a difficult time getting the speed correct.
You're exactly right, Paige. This is one of the tougher two putts on the course, and the first 80% of it is steeply uphill, but actually manages in the last 5 or 6 feet to go away from you. So extremely difficult to get the pace just right.
Did so well to make a nice putt on the very first hole after kind of getting out of sorts to save her par. We'll see if the putter can come through again.
This needs to settle.
Well, that will be a test.
And up ahead, one at the 7th. This is Lindblad for bogey now. Ingrid Lindblad knows how to win golf tournaments four-time first-team All-America during her time in Baton Rouge at LSU. Some work to do for back right now. A return to the sixth.
And Gianna Clement now.
This is a little easier than you.